Today we're in the Alstom facility in Derby. We've been making trains here for nearly 200 years.
What we're going to do is we're going to show you around this mock-up space that we've got here in Alstom's facility. We've got lots of areas of the train mocked up. So there's an example of every user-facing part of the trains. We've been using these mock-ups over the last 3 years to improve, validate, change, tweak various areas of the train design to make sure that it is as user-friendly as possible. All of the mock-ups that you're going to see are all deliberately painted in grey and white. This isn't representative of the final finish, but we've deliberately painted them in this colour so that when we're testing with members of the public, people aren't distracted by the colours. We're doing this deliberately so that we're testing the function of the space. And we're going to first look at an early mock-up of the platform train interface. So the platform train interface is how the train will arrive at the platform and how customers will board and alight the train.
And one of the things we've learned significantly since doing the testing with many different users of all types of ability is the grab handles with them being recessed. It was quite difficult with people with reduced mobility, say arthritis, to actually be able to use the grab handles to both alight and exit the train. So this is one of the things that we've changed as a result of doing user testings.
Here we are in a mock-up of the standard class saloon. So just in front of me here, we are in two of the four wheelchair spaces on this train, two of them in standard and two of them in premium. And we've tested this with a variety of wheelchair users and got some incredibly useful feedback. Most of the train has got these overhead luggage racks here, and they used to extend over the wheelchair space as well. But the feedback was that sometimes wheelchair users have assistants, companions with them, and those assistants were starting to bang their heads as they were trying to help the wheelchair user. Whilst we were really keen to maintain an equity of provision across the whole of the interior, we actually found that the overhead luggage racks were giving a negative effect, so those have been removed. Secondly, what you might notice, if I stand in the wheelchair space here, there is no window here. So in the early iterations of the design, the wheelchair users weren't going to get a very good view out of the window, and that's clearly unacceptable. So one of the big design changes we've made is that we've now moved the wheelchair spaces slightly so that the window now extends here. So this white outline represents where the window will be. One of the absolute best things about this train is the amount of legroom that you'll have when you're traveling. We've tried so hard on this train to make sure that everybody can use it comfortably. We've done lots of testing on the legroom and it's received positive feedback.
We've had a number of users who have to use guide dogs, and one of the feedback we've had was because there is so much space in between the seats, it allows him to get his dog to be able to sit underneath his legs, whereas previous on normal trains, poor old dog has to sit in the aisle. That was really great feedback.
So the seats that Niall and I are sat on now are representative of good quality seats that you might put on a modern train, but they are not the seats that we're going to get for the HS2 train. We've done lots of testing with these seats and with these tables to make sure that we've got best balance of capacity and comfort for the passengers.
These are what's known as the development seats. And we spent an awful lot of time working with various different user groups to come up with the optimum seat. So a good example of this is we've got a device holder here where you can place your phone. You can also plug it into the USB cable here. The feedback from different user groups is that was fantastic because they don't like to reach down and fiddle about trying to find a location for the USB port. Also, we've got a sliding table where you could place an iPad. There'll be some grooves in here. So you can also fit a wide laptop on here with your cup of coffee or cup of tea. We've not only done mock-ups, we also use virtual reality. But the one thing with virtual reality is that you can't really grasp the spatial awareness. So you can imagine that, as James explained previously, it would have been very difficult for us to pick up the issue with the head clash if we were just using virtual reality. We get so much more valuable feedback that you couldn't ever achieve just from a paper review. Everything that we found on this and fed back into the design has saved thousands and thousands of pounds, because if you could imagine, we built vehicles and then had to modify them. It's so much more cost effective to find out these issues now rather than post-build.
It's all about making sure that everybody can use this train in the best possible way.